So first we have to check its zero error. So it's 2 units below zero. So we have to add 2 units with our each reading. So now we will find the least count of this screw gauge. So let us find the least count. So taking 1 turn, 2 turns, 3 turns, and 4 turns, we are seeing that by rotating 4 circular turns, the distance moved on the linear scale is 2 millimeters. So let us calculate the least count. So 4 rotations equals 2 mm. So it means 400 units, 400 divisions equal to 2 mm. So 1 division will be equal to 2/400 mm. So we will get 0.005 mm. So our least count is, least count of the screw gauge is 0.005 millimeters. Now we will proceed to find the radius of the experimental wire. So to find the radius of this experimental wire, we will just put this wire in this screw gauge. Now noting the reading. So it is 52 on circular. This is 52 divisions. So now we will check the how much rotations it has. So 1 rotation and half rotation. So it is total number of divisions are 152 divisions. So we have to calculate for 152 divisions. So 152 divisions multiplied by least count, which was 0.005 millimeter, so it turns out to be 0.76 millimeters. Now we have to check the diameter again at a perpendicular position. So perpendicular position is like this. So it is again 51, 2 and 3. So it is 53. So total divisions are 153. So we have to multiply it with least count again. So 153 divisions multiplied by least count. So it turns out to be 0.765 mm. So in this way, we can check the diameter of the wire at 3 different places. So it is 54. So the number of divisions are 154. Now taking the reading at a perpendicular direction, so it comes out to be again 152. So 154 and 152. Now again, we will check the diameter at some other place. So it is again 152 divisions at a perpendicular position. So it is 150 divisions. So now we will fill the 0.76, 0.765. Now second reading is 0.77, 0.76, and 0.74, and 0.755. In this way we can take more readings. So now we will check the mean of these readings. So this will be 0.76, again this will be 0.765, and this will be 0.75. So now the mean will be 0.768 millimeters. So now we have to correct this diameter because we have a correction of two divisions. So now two divisions will be equal to multiplied by 0.005 millimeter. So it will be 0.01 mm. So we have to make a correction in this diameter, so which will be 0.768 plus 0.01 mm, so which will be equal to 0.778 mm. Now we have to take the reading in centimeters. So this will be equal to 0.0778 centimeters. So now the corrected diameter of our wire is 0.0778 centimeters. Now our radius of the wire is 0.0389 centimeters.